I've asked you to have a look at Harel's original paper. In there, he has several abstract diagrams laying out the various features of the state chart notation. On the left, there's a state machine that has three states. Notice the default state is the top one and with the line coming into it. And there are transitions among the states. Totally, there are six transitions there. The version on the right, labeled B, okay, is a nested state transition diagram. A new state called D in the round tangle surrounds states A and B. A is still the default state for the state machine as a whole, but notice that some of the lines come out of D rather than coming out of either A or C. Going back to the one on the left, notice there are two transitions labeled F, one coming out from A and going to B, one coming out of C and going to B. On the right, they're coming out of D. That is, there's an abstraction saying when you leave any state in D under transition F, you go to B. So in that case, we've reduced two transitions labeled F to one. There's still the transition from A to C. There's still the transition from B to A. Notice also, though, that there's a transition from B to D labeled H. In this case, where does it go? Well, notice that we've added a new default state and its transition for C. That is, if a transition comes into D, to the border of D, where is it going to go? It's going to go to the default state, which is C. Well, this is identical to what's happening on the left, where there's a direct line from B to C. In this case, the line's a little shorter, saving just a little bit of complexity. We could also have the nesting go further, that is, A or C or B could themselves have substate machines in them.